The beauty of each masterpiece is veiled inside its most profound message, which gives a new meaning to every viewer that sees it. One such masterpiece is 5 centimeters per second, embedded with love, emotions, and reality. What's going on, everyone? I'm Broken and Obsessed in My Otaku Ways, and today we're digging into the world of 5 centimeters per second. So without further ado, be sure to hit that subscribe button if you're new here, and press that tiny bell icon. Now let's begin.
秒速 5
センチなんだって。え?何?桜の花の落ちるスピード。秒速
5 センチメートル。
If you don't know what love is, then watch it. If you're still in love or moved on, then really watch it. 5 centimeters per second incredibly covers all states of love and emotion. It reflects the hidden message behind metaphorical narrations. Moreover, a movie under the direction of Makoto Shinkai needs no reason to experience it. Like his other great works, this movie is also well-crafted and designed in a unique way of storytelling. 5 centimeters per second is an anime romance movie, because, you know, this is an anime channel, based on a childhood love story in Japan. The movie also holds record of the best anime feature film of 2007 by Asia Screen Awards. The movie is centered around Takaki Tono's love life and his crush, Akari Shinohara. Another role played is Kane Sumida, who narrates her own story, but beautifully convinces us to stay focused on the main character, Takaki. Background anime is well synchronized, thoroughly relates to the story and the characters. 5 centimeters per second unfolds its story into 3 episodes, and each episode opens with a new title and a new timeline that really attracts its viewers to search for the meaning of the title in the story. The first episode is named Cherry Blossom, which starts with the story of Takaki Tono in 1993. Who meets with Akari at school when they both are just 13 years old, and they're both transfer students, so it makes the similarities bring them even closer. They spend most of the time with each other, and in this innocence both fall in love, but like every love tale, time disjoins them, does not allow them to mingle anymore. Akari tells Takaki that she is leaving school and home due to her parents' job, but they keep writing letters to overcome the loneliness of their tormented hearts. Akari states in a letter that she keeps a close eye on every season and has a giant cherry tree whose petals fall at 5 centimeters per second, because, you know, that's the name of the show. They probably don't know that once a petal falls apart, it never becomes a flower again. The same happened with them, like Takaki and Akari had to shift to another city. It widens their distance even further. Takaki decides to see her as he writes a love letter to her. He travels on a bullet train, gets more than 10 minutes late on every station due to bad weather. Besides, on his way, the love letter slipped out from his hand and flew away with the wind. But Takaki does not lose his hope. Instead, he thinks more about her. When he reaches the final station after being late for hours, he becomes shocked to see that Akari is still waiting for him. Finally, they manage to celebrate a romantic night. Akari brings him to the cherry tree where they kiss and spend the whole night side by side. And if you've ever had a long distance relationship where you know you're really, really happy to see that person, but in your heart, you know just as well as they do that it's not gonna last because you eventually have to go back. And that's just one of the main reasons why this show hit me so much, is because I've experienced the same thing as I'm sure a lot of you have. But let me continue. On the next day after departure, Takaki realizes the short night lasted more than a century in his heart, and the warmth of her lips was more than any feeling you could imagine. He thinks he can spend the remaining rest of his life with it, while Akari does not give Takaki the letter that she wrote for him. Cherry Blossom is meant to be the symbol of love and new beginnings, and the first episode magnificently tells us what love is. The feeling, the desire to live for each other, its power to stand against hurdles and hope. Whether it happens in childhood or at any age, it makes a person care less about reality. Interestingly, the chapter closes as Takaki decided not to give Akari the letter because he lost it on the train, and Akari not giving Takaki the letter that she wrote for him, thus dragging us into the next session of this beautifully tragic story. Unlike the Cherry Blossom, Cosmonaut, the second episode starts in the voice of a new character, Kanai Sumeda. Now Takaki is in the third year of high school in Tanegashima, and yes, I do know that my pronunciation is off, forgive me. Kanai captivates herself by Takaki. She tries to meet him, and they hang out every day after school, but Takaki does not observe her love. She notices him writing texts to somebody, but Takaki, in obsession, deletes each email after writing them. He does not send it to anyone. After days, Kanai thinks, if she doesn't say it to today, she would never confess her feelings, ever. Exactly that happens though. She desperately starts weeping after a failed attempt. Takaki, in surprise, looks at her. Suddenly, a rocket takes off near the city. Both start watching it. While looking at the rocket, she changes her mind instantly. It seems like that rocket left all the answers for her in the smoke. She convinces herself that Takaki never looked at her as she thought. He is special, but someone is more valuable for him, as he always sees everyone from afar like he is waiting for somebody more special, and we all know who that is. There's a scene of almost 2 minutes long about the rocket launch and its smoke. Flight of Cosmonaut is metaphorically used in the story with words and without words, that we humans make heavy rockets because we are desperate to see beyond this world. The rocket does not change its direction, nor does it look around. Kanai realizes that Takaki is like Cosmonaut. He's not gonna stop for anyone. His destination is someone special. And another sad, harsh reality about myself, just so you guys know a little bit more about me, is it really hurts because I understand what it means to want somebody so bad, but know that they want somebody else. Somebody is more special to them. And it hurts you, but at the same time, you understand, because it would be the same way if the shoes were in reverse. I fucked that saying up, but bear with me here. 5 centimeters per second is the name of its final chapter. It's now 2008, and Takaki is now a programmer in Tokyo, whereas Akari is preparing to marry someone. Takaki is still in the limbo of first love, detrimental to his lifestyle. He receives a call from his current girlfriend, but does not answer her deliberately. Perhaps he wants to clarify that he is no more interested in her. Desperate, Takaki quits his job. He starts wandering on the roads, and stops at a magazine shop. He picks up a decade-old magazine of the rocket. In the next scene, we see Akari. She finds a love letter that she didn't give him. In the end, Takaki and Akari narrate their love dream, where both wish someday they would catch cherry blossoms together again. 5 centimeters per second is used in the first episode, where cherry trees' petals fall at 5 centimeters per second, but as a title of episode 3, its meaning is life after departure. Takaki and Akari know that with each passing day, the distance between them is growing. Both still love each other, but Takaki is suffering while Akari is starting a happy new life with the same belief that one day they would see the cherry tree again. Regardless, I believe the story is still too short because I never got my fucking happy ending, which, you know, I was left crying like previous episodes in my channel, but, you know, quick plug. But it metaphorically delivers its diverse message. People who fall in love mostly ignore reality and suffer for the rest of their lives if they depart. In addition, the three characters express three different types of personalities that exist in our society. For example, people like Akari learn fast. As she learned more quickly, Takaki could not become her life partner, so she decided to start a new life by getting married to someone else. While on the other hand, Takaki suffered more than anyone because of his inability to accept reality. These people ruin their life in sadness and hope. The unrealistic approach leads them to depression and pain, which I can relate to that, sadly. As, you know, it's just depressing. But, the third type of people are like Kanai. These people possess both qualities. We can call them balanced humans for a better term. There are some other interpretations of this movie, like the essence of Love Never Ends. In a nutshell, I'm trying to conclude everything with these words. In the race of love and time, time always wins, but love never gives up. It renews the lover again and again, no matter how far the time takes us away. And with that, I hope you guys cry as much as I do if you watch this or if you have seen it. Not that I wish you guys to be sad, it's just really fucking depressing. But I've been broken obsessed in my otaku ways, and I will see you lovely people next time. I forgot there was a minute.